So hello everyone. Today we'll be solving on another leetboard hard problem that is called like arithmetic slices to subsequence. So in this problem we have been given an integer array nums, and we need to return the number of all the arithmetic subsequences of the nums. So now what is an arithmetic subsequence? So it has been defined as a sequence of numbers which consist of at least three elements, and if the difference between any two consecutive element is same, then it can be said to be a arithmetic subsequence. So let us take some examples. So for example, this 13579 is an arithmetic subsequence because it has got five elements, and the condition, like this criteria, says that there should be at least three elements, and this difference between each consecutive element is two. Similarly, this 7777 is also an arithmetic subsequence because it has got four elements, and the difference between the consecutive element is 0 here, and here the difference between is the consecutive element is 2, and this is not an arithmetic sequence because here the difference is 0 and here the difference is 1, so the difference is not same. And a subsequence of an array is a sequence that can be formed by removing some elements of the array. So like if there is an array and we are removing some elements out of that array, then the remaining thing can be called a subsequence. So that is a standard definition. Now, like the problem says one more thing, that the test cases are generated so that the answer fits in 32-bit integer. So basically we need to return the answer in an integer, and they guarantee that the answer would fit in this integer range. So let us take a look at the constraint first. So this, there are like less than equal to 1000 elements in the nums array, and the elements of the nums array have the ranges of the integer. So seeing the ranges, we can see that if we'll try to add two elements of the nums array, it may result into overflow. So it will be a safer practice to use longs as much as possible in this problem, even though the final answer will be an integer. So we may take an example. So here, in this example, there is an array containing the elements 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10, and there are 7 arithmetic subsequences. So one is 246, another is 468, and so on. And there is one more example in which there is an array containing 57. So the answer has been said to be 16. So any subsequence of this array is arithmetic. So any subsequence having length 3 or more will be an arithmetic subsequence, because the difference is always 0. So only criteria we need to fulfill is the minimum length. So the number of subsequences, arithmetic subsequence, will be 5c3. Plus 5c4 plus 5c5. So that will be 1 plus 5 plus 10, that is 16. So that is also correct. So now generating the calculating the arithmetic subsequences of length at least 3 would be a tough task. We can do one thing, we can find out the number of all the subsequences of length greater than equal to 2, and we can then subtract all the subsequences of two length present in the array. So basically the number of subsequences of length 2 in the array is straightforward, that is nc2, which is n into n minus 1 by 2. So finding the arithmetic subsequences where the length is greater than or equal to 2 will do this will be sufficient. So let us see how can we do that. So we can pick any two element and form a sequence of two, form an arithmetic subsequence of two elements, and we can use the difference between these two elements as a criteria for extending this sequence. So just in case we are able to find another element so that the difference between these and these two are matching the starting difference, then we can extend this array. So this problem, seeing the extension thing, we can see that this problem may be able to be solved by dynamic programming approach. So let us consider one state, and this state is i comma div. So basically this thing represent the number of arithmetic subsequences whose last element is the nums I, and it has got difference div throughout the subsequence. So we can find this number of this dp I comma div by summing all the dp j comma div plus 1, where the div is nums i, minus nums j. So basically, since the nums I minus nums j is ref, we can add this nums I to this arithmetic subsequence ending at nums j to form the new subsequence. And this one is like we are adding this one also, because we can form another subsequence of difference diff by just using this nums I comma nums j, these two elements. That's why we are doing this. So we can do it for every j that is less than or equal to I, and then we will have, after doing it over the array, like we will have the computation like values of all the db I comma diff, and then we can add all these things to get the total number of subsequences, arithmetic subsequences of length greater than or equal to 2, and then we can like subtract n into n minus 1 by 2 to get the final answer. So let us try to implement this. So first I will be storing the size of the nums array in integer n, and we will need a dp. No, so we can't use a 2D matrix, because like the ranges of these numbers are of the order 10 to the power 9, and the differences are also of that order, so we can't use a dp like dp array for calculating these things. So we are forced to use an unordered map, and for representing this state I am defining a hash, and I will call this key to be diff into 2000 plus I. The reason why I am using 2000, because I is ranging from 1 to 1000, so multiplying it with 2000 will keep this key unique. So I will be mapping long int to long int, and we can call this to be subs comp. Now we can start the for loop. So I'm starting from 1, because like for I equal to 0 there won't be any case, because like we are not able to, we cannot form a subsequence with only one element, and it will go up to n, and then we can have another loop for j that is stand for every like every index less than I. Now like we can calculate the diff. So that is diff is nums I minus nums j. So like since nums I and nums j are integer, like it may be possible that while subtracting them it will result into overflow of integer. So it will be better if we will convert them into long and then do the computation. Now we can like form a key for this key, like we can form a hash value for this key. So that will be, I will call it key current, and it will be def into 2000 plus I. And similarly, the key for previous state will be key prev. It will again def into 2000 plus j. Now we need to do this thing, and that is straightforward. We can do subs count, and it will be key current plus equal to subs count key previous plus 1. So basically this, after running these loops, like these two loops, we will have all the like data for all these states, and now we can sum all they of them to get the total number of subsequences. So for that I am using an iterator. It will start from this count.begin, and it will go up to subscount.end. And we can add the count of each state to get the total number of subsequences. In the end, we can do subtraction of the number of states consisting of number of subsequences consisting of only two elements. And since we were required to return the answer in the form of teaser, we can cast it in teaser. So the complexity of this whole program is like order of n into n, because this loop is order n, this loop is order n, so it's order n squared, and this is an order one operation. And like this can be at most order n squared. So basically this is order n squared algorithm. So seeing the constraint, it should pass the test cases. Let us try running it. Yeah, so we were using LL for representing long int data type. So let us do this. So let us define it. Yeah, now this should work. So basically, we need to use second for getting it. Yeah, so we can submit it. So it got submitted. So thank you guys for attending this tutorial.